In this video, we're going to take a look at the creation of baseline and chain dimensions in an Autodesk Inventor drawing. On this part, I would like to add in linear dimensions for the horizontal distance as well as locate the centers of each of these holes. While this can be done by placing several general dimensions, I am instead going to use the chain and baseline tools. I'll begin with the chain tool. I'll select the chain dimension tool here in the Annotate tab. And for this one, I'm simply going to select all of the geometry I wish to dimension. So I'll start by selecting the left side line here, the circles that I wish to dimension to, and the right side of the part. Then I will right click and continue. As you can see, it generates a chain of dimensions and I can simply click to place them, then right click and create. And just like that, I've quickly placed my chain of dimensions. Similarly, I can create some baseline dimensions. So if I want to use one of the shapes as my datum and have all dimensions come off of it, I'll select my baseline dimension tool. By default, the first object I select is going to act as the datum. So I'll select the left side line first here. Then I will select each shape from there. Then right click and continue. As you can see, it's creating the baseline dimensions off of that left side, since that's the first location that I clicked. You can change your datum though. If I decide that I want the right side to be the datum, I'll hover over the right side extension line, right click and select Make Origin. Now you can see the right side is the datum and all dimensions are coming from there. Or maybe the center hole was my locating hole. I can right click on this one and make it the origin and all dimensions come from this center hole now. I'll go ahead and return it to the left side here. Click to place my dimension, right click and create, and there I have my baseline dimensions. So whether you want to create chain dimensions or baseline dimensions, there you have two quick alternatives to using the general dimension tool.